All right, we're gonna show you what a Tesla-style radio looks like in a 2012 Chevy Cruze. As you can see, this is what it looks like when it's off. So now I'm gonna show you what it looks like when it's on. The only thing about these radios is that they are perfectly made to fit the dashboard, and it comes with the wiring harness that is specifically designed for this car. So you ain't gotta worry about unhooking any cutting any wires, or buying any kits for the radio to fit. It perfectly fits in. Just be aware, you gotta take all this off here. You gotta take all this off, and put this down in neutral with emergency brake on to get this off to get to the other two bolts. It's fairly easy, but if you don't know what you're doing, have somebody help you. That is how to do it professionally, like a friend, family member, or somebody at a stereo place. But you shouldn't have any problems. I would buy an interior plastic removal tool, which I have, and it makes it a lot easier than breaking your clips. This radio is a J300. It was made for 08 to a 2012, but they claim they fit for 14. Now, as you can see, that's what mine looks like. I don't have the AC controls working because mine's manual, so it doesn't give me the option. It's grayed out. But I've seen a couple of other videos where these radios have more wires than some of them. And mine has less, only has like a couple wires for like antenna and for like Sirius XM radio and all that stuff. I had to cancel my Sirius XM radio because these radios don't come with them. They have built-in Bluetooth, works for phone calls, music. You can play games on this thing. It has built-in Wi-Fi navigation. My navigation works. The Wi-Fi works as long as your phone has it. You can use hotspot or whatever, and it works famously. If you want to see what your settings look like, you just go to settings. You have, like, this option here. It shows you, like, where all the ports go and stuff. You just like hit like A or B, C, D, or F, and it'll tell you exactly how many pins it is for that port. Look at them, because on the instructions on this one, it was kind of reversed, like upside down. So I was wondering why my USB port cables weren't working for like the flash drives. It was because it was on the opposite. It was basically upside down, and this was giving me the right info. You have like your system information that tells you like my screen revolution. It's got Android 10.1. It had 9.1, but it was upgraded, because I guess because of an update. 1 gig of RAM, 16 gig flash. Have like your sound settings. As you can see, you can change it to like classical, dance, heavy metal, hip hop, funk, jazz, pop, rock. I keep on custom. I just reset it. I got to get used to the sound, because my other radio had a little more bass than this one did. But I think eventually I'm gonna have to get new speakers. When one of them actually blows is when I'm actually gonna do it. But right now I'm not going to, because nothing in this car is broke, so I'm not gonna mess with anything else that I don't need to mess with. You got factory settings. Just so you know, the code is 8888 for all these radios. Mine didn't come with a code, but I looked on another video, and that's what it said, and that's what it popped up with. These are other settings you'll just have to go through and look at. I'm not going to sit here and go through every single one of them. But I'll show you like an example, like tire pressure settings. Tell us what your tire pressure settings are. This is like factory. You can go back and mess with another one here. Like color settings. As you can see, it's all factory. I don't really mess with any of these settings because they're already factory set. You get like your mute settings and so on and so on. Now, just go through them and see what you want to do. You got like USB settings, touch settings, app settings, you know. It's a pretty cool little thing. I mean, it just doesn't show unless you enter that password. So if it doesn't work for yours, then it means that yours probably has a different password, but mine sure as hell does. You got car settings, as you can see. It just tells you that set the basic body and detailed information, operate the main unit with the original car panel keys and panel knobs. So you just hit set into car. It will show you things like for your OnStar, Language. Some people have different settings. This one's only shown for language. I don't know why. But this is what the original car settings is. You got things like for your tire pressure settings here. I don't think this car is going to read this because it's all on this screen. So I think for certain year models, I guess if they're not on the screen, I mean, if they're on the screen, I don't think it's going to show on the radio. So that's what that is. And you have these settings here. You know, you got your music settings for music. You got radio settings. Shows you the radio actually works. And you get your navigation. It's not going to work because I don't have... Well, maybe it would pop up. But the Bluetooth settings would work through USB, which is run through USB now. You can select for like repeat, pause, check your equalizer settings. You know, and you can still change your audio and stuff just like that. If you want to check like your Android settings, you hit go to settings. This is the same like for cell phone or tablet use. You have your normal settings like network, your app notifications, display, sound, storage, security, location, user accounts. Like I have my Google account linked to this. And you can get like on Facebook Messenger and stuff like that. For some reason, I can't download Hulu or Netflix on it. I think they don't allow you to for a certain reason. So they want you to mirror it through your phone. As you see, system updates 10.1. It had 9.1, but you can't update on your own for some reason. I think it does it automatically. Because when I opened it and started it the first time, it had 9.1. And you'll see what wallpapers you have. You can hold it down right here. You do it this way, and it'll show like what wallpapers you have and stuff. And you can just go through it. But I don't want to change mine. Because I like the darker screen when I actually drive. But you just have to go through and play with it. But you got things like volume settings. Show right there. You got brightness settings. Navigation settings. You choose which one you want to use. The normal Google or the one that came with the stereo. You got your GPS detection. Steering learn. You got logo settings, but I haven't figured out what that does. And you have your other settings. Well, I hope this video helps. Like I said, I bought this from eBay for like $165 plus $9 shipping. You can get it from other places, but it's more expensive like on Amazon. It's because it's like over $300, and I don't know why. But these do take like a week and a half to get. Please keep in mind, they only work on a 2008 to a 2012 Chevy Cruze with this radio here. So, if you want one, you need help installing it. I can help you install it with no problem if you live locally. But comment if you like, feel free, and have a great one.